Let's all have a look at Grace in her yellow sweater, shall we? Here she is, smiling away, looking lovely, and totally appropriately dressed. Especially for a 17-year-old high school student, because, well. Well, apparently her high school did not think so. Hello and welcome back to Inform Overload. Hey, hi, I'm Rebecca Felgate, and today we are talking all about a girl whose picture was ousted from the school yearbook. Now, this is all because they said that it was too inappropriate, but she's saying, hey, wait, no. Okay, so I've seen teenagers. I've been a teenager. What Grace is wearing here is totally appropriate and pretty darn modest. For example, I was just at a festival this past weekend, and some of the things that I saw young girls wearing, like, wow. A yellow sweater is practically an article of religious attire in comparison, so. Grace Gable from Illinois wore her yellow top for her yearbook snap, and despite the photographer saying nothing about it at the time, she was later asked to retake the picture because her clothes violate her school's dress code. Apparently, the school, Main South High School in Park Ridge, took issue with the very top of her shoulders.
Shoulders, right?
Bah. Grace was so upset that she'd been called out this way for an unassuming piece of clothing, so she actually started a change.org petition. In the petition, she stated that her shirt was appropriate and that she'd even worn it to school events in the past without anyone batting an eyelid. The petition calls for a change in the school's outdated dress code, asking for the rule that shoulders must be completely covered to be revoked. Grace said, and this is important to everyone, so listen up. I have spent a good majority of my life wondering why exactly women's shoulders are so offensive. It is ridiculous that young women aren't allowed to wear the clothing that they wish to wear simply because it could possibly distract someone. Shaming women for wearing the things that make them feel comfortable and happy in their bodies is horribly sexist and leads many girls to grow up believing that if another individual cannot control their actions around women, that the woman was at fault. I'm just saying, preach, Grace. You preach. Grace is only 17, but she has an insight that few people that are much older than her have. You will be pleased to know that as of the end of last week, the principal from Maine South had contacted her and decided that the picture was allowed to be included in the yearbook after all. I'm really glad because she looks fantastic and she looks totally appropriate. He also added that he will look at revising the outdated dress code, so I'm saying victory for Grace. I love her, Queen Grace taking down the establishment. Well done, girl. If you're watching, Grace, shout out to you. Shoulders are cool. So before I wrap up this video, I just wanted to reply to a couple of comments from a video I did last week about an alleged ghost caught on Snapchat. Spooky. Legendary Pusheen said, it's fitting how it's on Snapchat because their icon is a ghost. You're right, lol. Nitin Sharma said, Rebecca dances a lot while talking. All those hand gestures. Maybe it's an English thing. That's for you. I don't think it's an English thing. I think it's a Rebecca thing and I've lost my mind. Also, shout out to all of you who commented on my hair. Yes, my top knot did unravel mid-video, producing what can only be described as a miniature shark fin. And sure, nobody told me, but you know what? Who cares? Because sharks are cool and so's shark hair. I'm repping shark hair. Next time, I'm gonna bring it back. Also, if you wanna replicate shark hair, do it and tweet me at Rebecca Felgate, and I'm gonna be retweeting all that shark hair all day, every day. So that is all I have on this video. Do you think that Grace's picture was inappropriate? Or do you, like me, think she looked fantastic? Do you think that she did the right thing by starting a petition? And do you believe that the right result came out of it? Let me know the answers to all of these questions in the comments section down below. For now, I'm Rebecca Felgate. Thank you so much for tuning in to IO. If you like this video, make sure you give it a good thumbs up. Share it with a friend and stay subscribed for more daily news. I'll see you next time.